Good morning students, this is the video lecture of class 11th physics of chapter vector and this is the third video lecture, third part of the vector. Now today we are going to discuss about the analytical method of vector addition. In previous video we have already discussed about the how we add the two vector, three vector. Now this is the method. In W method we have seen that when we add the head of the vector to the tail of the vector, when we add head to tail, then we can add the magnitude of the vector in a very simple method if this two vectors are in a linear way. But suppose that if these two vectors making some angle between them, then how can we add this two vector, three vector, more than two vector? Then we have a very best method for this. Then today we are going to discuss about the two methods of adding the vectors, and they are the triangle law of vector and parallelogram law of vector addition. So today we are going to see how we can add the vectors when they have angle between them. In previous topic we have already told you that whenever we are going to add vector or whenever you are going to take the angle between two vectors, then we always take a smaller angle. And how can we find out the angle between them? Whenever we want to find out the angle, this we have the very simple method. This is the vector A and then we take the vector B. So this is the angle. So this becomes the angle of the vector. It means when you keep the two vector or joined by the tail, then the angle between them becomes the angle of the vector. Not bigger one, take always a smaller one. So here we are going to see how can we add this vector by the process, by the method of triangle law vector. So what is triangle law vector? This triangle law vector says that according to this law of, if two vectors are represented both in magnitude and direction by the adjacent side of a triangle taken in same order, then the resultant is completely given in magnitude and direction by the closing side. It means what? If we take the two vectors, suppose that this is the vector A and this is the vector B, if we want to find out the angle between this, if we want to find out the resultant vector this R, then first of all we have to take this vector A and then we head to the tail, we add head to tail, then this is the vector A and this is the tail, vector B, this is the vector B, then we keep just like this, then this closing side of the triangle gives the resultant of the vector. So this side gives the resultant of the vector. So this R becomes resultant of the vector. So here the two vector enclosed to each other at angle theta. So these are the two vector, vector A and vector B. Now we have to do some construction in this very triangle, so we can easily find out this value. So first of all we draw a perpendicular line from Q to N and then we produce this line OP to N. So here from Q draw QN, we draw here QN and perpendicular to OP, which meets OP at N, which meets OP at N. It means when we produce this OP to N, then we draw a perpendicular line from Q to N. Now it becomes a right angle triangle. Now we have a method, that is the Pythagoras method, by which we can easily find out this value by this square plus this square equal to this square. We have already studied in the previous class. Now, but here problem. The problem is what? We don't know value of this one and this one. So for knowing the value of this P and or QN, so from right angle triangle QPN. So here we see that what is the value of QN. So we know that QN upon QP is equal to sine theta. We know that sine theta is equal to P upon H. So this is the perpendicular and this is the base. So QN upon QP is equal to sine theta. So we want to find out the value of this QN. So QN is equal to QP sin theta, and we know that the value of QP is equal to B. We know that PQ is equal to B. So here qn equal to b sin theta. Qn equal to b sin theta. Now, what is the value of this pn? The value of pn becomes here, once again we take pn upon qp is equal to cos theta. This one upon this one is equal to cos theta. So here, this pn is equal to what? Pn is equal to qp cos theta. So its value become pn is equal to b cos theta. Now we got the value of each side. Now it becomes b sin theta, and this become b cos theta. Now it become vector A, it is b cos theta, it become vector B, and it is b sin theta. Now we have to find out this one. Now we have to use the Pythagoras theorem. Now according to Pythagoras theorem, we do want here we see that this OQ square, it is equal to ON square plus QN square. This is our value. So first we put the value of this. So here our value is OQ square equal to, we write here ON. ON is equal to OP square, OP plus PN square plus UN square. Now put the value. When we put the value, we got the here answer. This OP is equal to A plus B cos theta square plus B sin theta square. Now A plus B square equal to A square plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta plus B square sin square theta. Now here is the value. Now we separate this, it become A square plus CA. It's B square sin square theta plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. Now we take here common, it become A square plus B square, and it become sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2AB cos theta. So it becomes sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So it become A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. This is the value. Now the value of this OQ, we put here R square. So we remove this square, so R become under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So this is the value of R resultant factor. This is the value of resultant factor of this. So this R become under root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. This theta is the angle between this two factor. So this is the value of the resultant term. Now we want to find out the direction, because whenever we do this, whenever we want to find out the resultant vector, then we know that the sum of the two vector is always gives a vector. So here the value of R become, here this value of direction of R is become tan alpha. So this is supported alpha. So this tan alpha is equal to, we know that this one upon this one, qn upon on, q Qn upon On, and we know that the value of this Qn, so it becomes B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. But this is the value of tan alpha. So this is the direction by which we can find out the direction of this vector, and by this we can find out the magnitude of this vector by the method of triangle of addition of vector. Okay, that's all. Now